بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم and good day everybody. My name is Dr. Ahmed Al-Khunezi and I am a consultant nephrologist at Johns Hopkins Aramco Healthcare. Johns Hopkins Aramco Healthcare celebrates the World Kidney Day every year. And this year it is March 11th. Because of the corona pandemics, we have decided this year to hold this activity virtually. So what I'm going to talk to you today about is organ donation and how it saves lives. This slide shows you the magnitude of organ failure in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. So currently we have around 20,000 people with end-stage kidney disease who are maintained on dialysis. These patients, they cannot live without dialysis. So dialysis is a life-sustaining type of treatment. When we look at the organ failure in general in the kingdom, we have around 20,000 people who are waitlisted to get an organ. So 7,000 people have kidney failure who are waiting for a kidney transplant. And the rest are distributed between liver, heart, and lung. So this is really a major problem our country is facing right now. Patients who are maintained on dialysis, they have poor survival. So the median survival is around 31 months. What we mean with median survival, just imagine there are 100 people with end-stage kidney disease who are starting dialysis today. So after 31 months or 2.5 years, 50 patients will have died by then, and the other 50 patients will be alive. In other words, the 5-year survival for patients who are on dialysis and who are diabetics is around 20%, i.e. a person with diabetes who is on dialysis have only 25% of being alive 5 years after they start dialysis. The outcome is a little bit better for patients who are not diabetic, so the 5-year survival is 30 to 40%. So overall, the survival is very poor, and it is similar to the survival of patients who have lung cancer, which is one of the worst cancers that we know. Why do we talk about organ donation? Organ donation has many benefits. First of all, organ donation saves lives. So patients who are on dialysis, they only live for a short period of time, and the kidney transplantation saves their lives. Organ donation also improves the quality of life. Just imagine somebody who is maintained on dialysis. These patients, they go for dialysis on average 3 times per week, and they spend 4 hours on the machine. And they need to be prepared for around 30 minutes before dialysis starts. And after dialysis ends, they need to be monitored for at least 30 minutes. So basically, they spend 5 hours in the dialysis unit 3 times per week. And that actually impacts their quality of life, as well as the quality of life of people that surround them, their families, friends, and people who look after them. In addition, organ donation is very cost effective. Take, for example, how much money hemodialysis costs per year, huge amount of money, while kidney transplantation, especially after the first year, is relatively very cheap compared to dialysis. So the society actually saves lives and saves money by doing organ transplantation. Unfortunately, we have severe shortage of organs in the kingdom, and there are very few people who are considered donors. And the list for patients who are waiting for an organ transplant gets longer and longer. There are different types of organ donation. What do we mean with that? There is living related kidney donation, i.e. a brother can donate a kidney to his brother or sister. And the other types is living unrelated. And that means somebody donates an organ to somebody they are not related to them genetically. So a husband can donate an organ to his wife and vice versa, or a friend can donate an organ to his or her friend. The other types of organ donation is what we call cadaveric organ donation or diseased persons, kidney donation. And that, and this is a patient who is brain dead. The heart still pumps, still functions, but the brain is destroyed. For an example, somebody who gets involved in a motor vehicle accident and they sustain severe brain damage, severe bleeding in, inside their head. So they are considered brain dead if there is no brain function. And these patients could be a very important source of organ donations, because many organs could be donated from these patients. For instance, a live donor can only donate certain organs like kidney, liver, and lung. However, a diseased person can donate many more organs. They can donate, besides the liver, lung, and liver, they can donate pancreas and heart. They also can donate tissues like bone, cornea, and the skin. And these tissues cannot be donated from live persons. So that's why we consider a diseased donor as a very important source of organs and tissue. There are common myths surrounding organ donations in general. So the first one is an organ donation is against religion, and this is absolutely not true. The other myth is that kidney donation may lead to disfiguring the body, and this is not true. When we retrieve organ from a live or diseased person, we do it in a very gentle way, similar to doing a surgery. Some people believe that they are too old or too sick to donate organs, and this is not true, because what really important is how healthy the person is. A few years ago, الأمانة العامة لهيئات كبار العلماء in the kingdom has issued a fatwa legalizing organ donations regardless of the source, whether it is live or disease donor organ donations. So you can rest reassured that organ donation is not against your religion. And this is also allowed by the other religions besides Islam. And this is the English translation of the fatwa for people who are interested to read it. There are a few questions that I would like to address. And the first one is, who can become a donor? And the answer is every healthy person could be a donor. The age is not a limiting factor. So anybody who is healthy, regardless of the age, could donate organs. What really matters here is the physical condition of the person. So somebody who is 70 and has good physiques, no medical problems, could donate organs. How to become an organ donor? You need to access the site of the Saudi Center for Organ Transplantation, SCOT. When you access this site, you can fill in the required information about you. And by doing so, you will be a registered donor. But before you do this, I encourage you to discuss organ donation with your family, because God forbid, after death, the final decision about organ donation will be in the hand of the family. So it is really important that your family is aware of your intention of organ donation, God forbid, after death. And with this, I would like to thank you very much for your attention. And I hope that next year, once the corona pandemic is over, we'll be able to meet face to face and address this important issue with you. Thank you very much and have a good day.